Greetings and welcome to an LGR racing game thing. And this is not the game we're going to be talking about. This is Forza Horizon 4, and I've been playing it incessantly since it came out. Easily one of my favorites of 2018, as should be no surprise if you know anything about my gaming tastes. And well, as per usual with any excellent new game release, I get to thinking about the titles that preceded it in one form or another. In the case of Horizon 4, it's just a fact that this game wouldn't be what it is today without the ground being laid by games like Test Drive Unlimited 1 and 2, Burnout Paradise, some of the Midnight Club games, heck, even the GTA series if you really want to get down to what's influenced open-ended vehicle-focused game design. And of course, that brings us to today's topic, Motor City Online, released by Electronic Arts in 2001 for Windows PCs. Race against thousands over the internet. Yes, indeed, this may not be open world, but it was a massively multiplayer online racing game from the turn of the millennium, one which I am absolutely unfamiliar with in just about every way. I mean, I knew it began and existed as sort of a spin-off of the Need for Speed series, being based on a lot of the engine code from High Stakes, but other than that, I'm fairly clueless as to what the actual gameplay is like. Sadly, I never got the chance to play it, though, because it was an online-only game. I only had a limited dial-up connection, and before I knew it, EA pulled the plug on the servers and killed the game off in 2003. Typical. However, that brings us to today and the fact that there is now an online patch available for the game. It's not perfect. It doesn't let you play online again, but it does let you mess around against AI, so let's give it a shot. I've provided links to the files in the video description, but yeah, once you have those, all you need to do is install MCO normally on a compatible PC and let that do its thing. After that, open up the MCity Update Archive and extract everything to the installation folder on your hard drive, overwriting anything it asks you to. Then there's the MCity Launcher, which is just a single executable that you move into the base installation directory. And finally, click over to the 3D setup folder there and open up the INI file, then change the hide resolutions equals one line to hide resolutions equals zero. Make sure it's not set to read only, save the file, and open up the 3D setup program itself, and now you can set the resolution properly. Although unfortunately, the only one that works is 800 by 600, no matter what you choose, it seems. But now you can open up that launcher program and there you go. Motor City Online can now be played offline to a degree. You can't actually go into any of the main menus or customize characters or anything, but you can choose from any of the vehicles, tracks, and race modifiers and launch directly into a single race. And man, doing this for the first time was quite a surreal moment. I never thought I'd be able to see this game in action for myself. Yeah.
Oh, nice! I've never seen this before.
Now, before I get too excited, let's move over to a place where I can capture this directly. Alright, that's better. Moved over to somewhere I can capture this directly. There are some interesting additions to this from, say, Need for Speed 4 or even 5, you know, Porsche Unleashed. Like, for instance, these reflections, you can do some really interesting options here as far as like per pixel, but also like full reflections of everything that's around you. It looks to be pretty accurate just when I was playing around with it a second ago, but also just the HUD. I mean, there's way more stuff that you can do here in terms of customization. I think this is pretty awesome, actually. Make it opaque or translucent. And there's all sorts of other indicators that are not in any of the other Need for Speeds that I really recall, like wind indication. What in the world? Okay. All sorts of different kinds of measurements for oil pressure, and this is also really cool too. So of course you can change the cameras as usual, but check this out. Like, say if I go here, you can choose individual distance can be customized, as well as the sort of height angle. Really, I would call that more like view angle, and this view angle is more like the field of view. And look at all these different adjustments for the audio. I mean, I know I'm harping on this options menu, but I'm really impressed for you know, an online MMO kind of thing. There's way more options, like individual, the skid volume, the collision volume, individual things like that are great. So anyway, let's just go ahead and play here. And here we go. This is Motor City Online, or at least What is playable of it? Oh, crap. What in the world? Physics are interesting. Let's just put it that way. They're very heavy. All the controls are identical to, like, the first five Need for Speed games. It definitely seems to be more based on, like, high stakes, but as in terms of the engine, but then there's also the, I don't know, just a lot of other parts of it that make it feel a little bit more like Porsche Unleashed. So I'm curious what the actual technicalities are in between. I haven't done any research before this video. I'm just kind of going on by what it feels like here. But yeah, like, the way it handles in particular feels a lot like Porsche Unleashed. In other words, it's garbage with a keyboard, which is what I'm playing right now. It's not something I would ever want to seriously try to do anything with. I would definitely be playing this with a steering wheel if this were actually online against other people. As it is now, I'm just against a couple AI characters, which is neat. You can also do all the kind of stuff that you would expect from, like, high stakes and further. So, turning on the lights like that. You have a left and right view. And then, as you can see, like, the windshield in the back, or the back glass, or any other glass, breaks in the same weird polygonal bits. And the damage model is predetermined and it smashes up almost identically, really, to high stakes. Oh, crap. You got the same little wrong way sound effect and everything. One thing that's a little bit different, though, there are different sound effects that change and, like, modify themselves as your car gets beat up. And then just a lot of other little additions like that that make it sound really interesting. Like, there's a specific idling noise that, again, changes based on how your engine's functioning or not functioning. The brakes start to squeal more as they get worn down. If you shift in the wrong gear, you can grind the clutch. Like, I don't know. Oh yeah, there's the brake squealing a little bit now because I'm in bad condition. Definitely adds to the feel of these cars being like a believable pile of junk. Like, overall, I'm impressed, which I did not expect at all, being an online game. I really thought that, I don't know, I just had a whole bunch of assumptions because I've never played this before. I've never seen it in action. And as you can see, I do have a totally different kind of skin on this car. So you're not just stuck with the one, you know, you've got actual liveries and stuff, I suppose. I don't know. I don't know how the game actually works, but, you know, because I can't go into the menus or anything. I would love to actually see what the career, so to speak, is and the progression and all that. But I mean, you can't do anything but this individual single races right here. This is it. That sucks. So you actually, you know, return to the lobby, quote unquote, which just drops you back to this launcher. And this launcher is the be all end all of what you can do with Motor City Online these days. Kind of sad, but at the same time, I'm just happy that there is a way to get this working. Let's go with a 442. And yeah, see, those are all the different skins there. So it's predetermined colors, but, you know, different textures to them, like the rust bucket's the one I had for the Challenger, or the Charger, just before this. Let's go with scallops. No, let's go with decals. And yeah, let's go against all the opponents. And we'll do something like tornado with weather. One thing I've noticed is that it kind of runs like crap no matter what. So you are restricted to a single resolution, 800 by 600, and it'll run at whatever color bit depth that your desktop is set at. So I've got it on a 32-bit right now. Chicken. That's pretty cool. But, I mean, this is a computer that, if you saw my XP build video, this thing's a monster for, you know, the mid-2000s. So it should be able to run this fantastically, but I'm in the, like, low 30s. Whoa, okay, there's the tornado. I was wondering if that would happen, if there'd actually be a tornado in here, because I saw that listed as the... Whoa, what the crap? There's, like, stuff flying around. Whoops. Ouch. Yeah, that totally swapped the engine noise there, or added to it anyway, I guess, maybe.
Anyway, what I was saying about the performance is it sucks no matter what. I've tried all sorts of different things. Like, this is a multi-core system, so I tried switching the Affinity, you know, forcing it to one core. That didn't work. You know, messed with VSync. I disabled SLI. I got one card going right now. Still doesn't seem to do anything. Triple buffering. I don't know. I've tried everything I can, and it just seems like it. There's either it's not well optimized, or it's just something weird with this patch. Okay, so I guess this isn't a... Oh my god! Seriously? That was not something I thought would happen. Can I run her over? Nope. There's a lot of little touches here I did not expect at all. Exploding gas tanks and like people you can kind of run over. Looks like she was running out of the way too. And like animals and stuff. Like these are just things that, I don't know, they weren't in any of the other Need for Speeds ever. Just about. That's really strange, but awesome. I am going the right, yeah, I'm going the right way. Man, this is really cool. It's making me more and more sad that you can't actually play the game anymore. Let's see what else is in here. Yeah, I saw some weird stuff sort of mentioned. Yeah, like what is this? 96 Toyota Supra. I really, like I said, I don't know anything about this, really how it originally worked. So I'm just kind of farting around here. Let's do Strip. It sounds like Las Vegas or something. Seems like night should be good. Let's do this. That is a Toyota Supra. How bizarre. This could be like a traffic... No, that doesn't make any sense. Anyway, if you know why this... Okay, this is really fast. If you know why this car was in here... What the crap? There's pedestrians! Dude, this is so cool! What the... Like, why didn't I even know about all this stuff? Dude. Oh, they just jumped up there. Did you see that? Get out of the way. Oh, I would have gone crazy for this in 2001. This is nuts. This is just such an odd thing to me. It's just like discovering another side of a very old friend that you didn't know. It's just like, dude, what? You did this? That's so cool. Oh. And yeah, there's like a radio. It's like a radio station with DJs and stuff. And look at all this like set dressing. Like this is some... I mean, I don't know, man. I'm just impressed here. This is crazy. No wonder people were so mad when this thing went down. Because 2001, like this is wild. I so wish this were still playable online with the rest of the game. Because I'm having fun here, just like dicking around. Like this, but oh, there goes that guy. It's my opponent. All right, let's see if there's another gas tank to blow up. Oh my goodness. Can I run that person over? She screams though. That's a nice touch. What in the world, man? Oh, kind of hit her there. I suppose that would have increased the rating. This is like rated E for everyone. Holy crap! Well, anyway, if you want to try it out, I mean, it's pretty easy to do so. I wasn't able to get it working on like a modern like Windows 10 system, at least Windows 10 64-bit. From what I've read, like 32-bit stuff is fine. It's just 64, it just freaks out, which makes sense. Game from 2001, typically it doesn't work well with 64-bit OSs. I might attempt some kind of a retrospective if I can piece together enough of what the game was like to play. And of course I can get some pretty decent footage here, but you know, I'm not gonna be able to do a proper full review because I can't go into the menus and do the actual like MMO stuff, creating your character and customizing cars and all that. Same with like The Sims Online. There's a free SO project that is very cool as well that does a similar thing, taking a previously dead online EA game, something that they killed, and then brings it back to life to some degree so you can experiment with it again. That I definitely gotta cover. This almost has like an early Midnight Club feel going on here. Or, you know, Midtown Madness, whatever, Angel Studios. I wanted to get to like the end of one track just to see what happens. Max 32 characters, I guess that's my name since it I wasn't able to put it in there. Okay, so we can watch replays. Get set, go! It's pretty neat. Oh, yep.
Gonna run these people over.
All right. And so, yeah, it looks like you can just restart or leave, which would return you to the lobby originally. But nope. Back to the launcher program. All right. Well, that's definitely it for this video. If you want to check it out, I will include some links in the video description for the patches and updates and all that kind of stuff that is needed. And I mean, of course, you're going to still need to find a disc. But yeah, anyway, give it a shot. Let me know if it works for you. Or if you have any memories of playing it back in the day, I'd love to hear how it was to actually play the full game. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching.